I started off as someone who was trying to write about the history of my city. And actually before starting artistic projects, I was doing a PhD about the history of my city. Simultaneously, I lost interest in the academic kind of study. I knew that I had to say something, and it would be easier for me to say it in an art project. With this film, I really played the part of the little guy who's messing about with other people's lives, mine included.
Tata era foarte la modă. Mama își purta părul ca o cântăreață neagră de funk, disco sau boogie. Tata avea plete ca un solist dintr-o formație rock. Lucrul ăsta nu era chiar așa obișnuit la vremea aceea. Bărbații primeau de multe ori sancțiuni de la partid sau de la fabrică pentru lungimea părului.
There was a mission behind the film, and that mission was to explain how it could be like or how it could have been like in Romania for a while. I was trying to kind of communicate very small day-to-day kind of information, but also information about the larger picture. So it was not only the personal or the historic, it was actually the idea of how you feel when you live there for a while.
153. Anul nașterii mamei mele. Într-o seară de mai, Stalin a închis ochii și nu s-a mai trezit niciodată. În Kiev, omorâse 3 milioane de oameni prin înfometare între 1932 și 1933. În Ucraina, murise un sfert din populație.
I wanted the film to be plausible. When you see it, you might have the impression that it might be true. And that was actually what I was aiming for. Because it is a mixture of fiction and biography and history.
Tata nu a ieșit în stradă, nici mama. În schimb, sora tatălui meu era acolo, printre demonstranți. A fost una dintre victime, omorâtă cu sălbăticie de mineri. Când Iliescu a apărut la televizor și le-a mulțumit minerilor, tata a luat televizorul nostru color și l-a aruncat de la balcon. După asta, s-a apucat să bea.
One could not say that it's entirely fictional or that it's entirely real. So I was aiming for some sort of logical coherence or some sort of credibility. And of course some fragments appear more true to life and some appear a bit far-fetched. I think the footage that I used is fictional only as far as a recording of historical events can be fictional. It didn't become, let's say, a part of my imagination just because I used it. I used it actually for its, let's say, reality kind of effect.
Am reușit cu greu să o filmez pe sora mea. În ultima vreme nu e niciodată acasă. Aici am rugat-o să stea un minut în fața trepiedului. Eram pe stradă și filmam chioșcurile din spațiul public. După ce minutul a trecut, sora mea a dispărut. Să se tundă, să-și caute droguri.
Literary theory really covers a lot of art theory. And so it really gave me, let's say, the intellectual background to understand what people were talking about when they were talking about the formal aspects of a work or something like that. Literature is about telling a story in a beautiful manner, while visual art is more about making a point, maybe, sometimes. And so when I wrote the script, I didn't really bother too much with embellishing the language or trying to make it beautiful in some way. I just went for the very kind of police-like or, let's say, scientific account of ordinary events. And also with the idea in mind that whenever you're talking about difficult histories or emotional problems, for instance, it is quite hard to communicate something when you're using a very connotated language, like when you're saying, oh, this was so painful. People will not believe that.
Mai târziu am continuat să fac lucruri, încercând să mă vindec și pe mine, dar și lucrurile stricate din jurul meu. Anul ăsta am făcut o proteză pentru o piatră spartă pe care o găsisem la marginea unui lac undeva în zona Marea Vlăsiei, la nord de București.
At least as language is concerned, in this film, the script is very much a dry account. It has no poetic feeling to the language that I wanted to include. I'm not sure I'm giving a correct account. And also, I'm quite sure it's a quite negative account. But I'm also sure that if you watch it, you get some information about how things could go in that sort of cultural context.